is Ludwig Vesemine, and today I want to talk about to share my opinion about global warming, how it's harming us, and if it is our fault that global warming is happening right now. The questions that I'm hoping to answer for you guys today: what's the difference between global warming and climate change? Some people might infer that global warming and climate change are the same thing, but some know that they have different meanings and different terms. And today I'm going to be explaining why they are different and what's the difference between them. Is the world really getting warmer than its average temperature? If so, are the actions of mankind to blame for the Earth's increased temperature? Are we the problem that Earth's temperature is increasing every single day? Or what can we should do about these issues? So first of all, what's the difference? If climate change is the long-term changes in climate, including average temperature and precipitation, it recognizes that although the average surface temperature may increase, the regional or local temperature may decrease or remain constant. As the global warming is the increase of Earth's average surface temperature due to a buildup of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. So many of you might be wondering, what is greenhouse gas? Let's see. So the greenhouse effect: when some sunlight that hits the Earth is reflected, sun becomes heat. Carbon dioxide, that most referred as CO2, and other gases in the atmosphere trap heat, keeping the Earth warm. These greenhouse gases last a long time. Carbon dioxide stays in the atmosphere for approximately 100 years, as methane lasts about 12 years. Other gases stay even longer. Warming gets more warming. For example, if these gases continue to raise the surface temperatures, they trigger to release of even greater quantities of carbon dioxide and methane that are currently trapped in frozen Arctic permafrost and tundra soils, further increasing temperatures. This is, for example, we took USA map that has 6.4 billion metric tons of carbon dioxide per year. Is the world really getting hot? According to ongoing temperature analysis conducted by scientists at NASA's Goddard Institute for Space Studies, that is mostly referred to as GICC, the average global temperature on Earth has increased by about 0.8 degrees Celsius, that is equals to 1.4 degrees Fahrenheit, since 1880. Two-thirds of the warming has occurred since 1975 at the rate of roughly 0.20 degrees Celsius, per decade. But why we should care about 1 degree Celsius? We live here every single day. Why doesn't it affect us? A 1 degree global change is significant because it takes a vast amount of heat to warm all the oceans, atmosphere, and land by that much. In the past, a 1-2 degree drop was all it took to plunge the Earth into a little ice age. A 5 degree drop was enough to bury a large part of North America to a mass of ice 20,000 years ago. If so, are the actions of mankind to blame for the Earth's increased temperature? The United Nations Panel of Climate Change experts today announced that mankind is almost certainly to blame for global warming, warning that the planet will see increasing extreme weather events unless governments take strong action. In a much-anticipated report released Friday, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, which is referred to as IPCC, said it's extremely likely that most global warming is man-made, asserting its claims with 95% certainty. Earth's atmospheric gases. You see that Earth's atmosphere is made up of different gases, that nitrogen, oxygen, which is mostly referred as non-greenhouse gases, make up of Earth's atmosphere 99%. And water, carbon dioxide, and methane, that is referred as greenhouse gases, make up only 1% of Earth's atmosphere. Future carbon dioxide levels. Increasing CO2 emissions, especially on China and developing countries. Life not a double within 100 years. Increased coal usage, increased natural gas usage, decreased petroleum usage, increased cost and decreasing supply. So, how can each of us help to slow global warming or to stop it from getting to us? Reduce our consumption of fossil fuels, because greenhouse gases emissions are tied very closely to our energy consumption. Using less fossil fuels-based energy could favor greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. This will help slow global warming. For example, the mountaintop removal for a coal mine near Rowell, West Virginia. 50% of electricity in the United States is produced from coal. Small changes can really add up. How can you save the world, and how small changes can help stop it? Replace your old refrigerator with a new Energy Star. So might have been wondering what is Energy Star. An Energy Star refrigerator is a refrigerator that certifies that it will use less energy than the old refrigerator, and it can save up your money, and it doesn't release that much of carbon dioxide. The annual savings of replacing your refrigerator will be 700 pounds of carbon dioxide. Set your thermostat down a few degrees in the window. Annual savings 1,400 pounds of carbon dioxide. Drive just 10 fewer miles per week. Annual savings 420 pounds of carbon dioxide. Wash clothes only in cold water. Annual savings 500 pounds of carbon dioxide. Reduce your garbage by 10% through greater recycling or reduce packaging. Annual savings 1,200 carbon dioxide. Blowing up your world. Hair dryers use a lot of energy. In the morning, so much energy is demanded to put on our grids that power companies have to find other sources of energy just to meet the morning rush hour. Our reliance on cars that burn fossil fuels is one of the major causes of increased level of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. It is primary cause of urban smog. Turning off lights saves energy and money. The more energy used, the more we are. Fresh vegetables cook more quickly and are usually nutritious than frozen or canned foods. Canned and frozen vegetables are often overprocessed, contain additives, contribute to air pollution, transport and packaging, and add to our waste problem. Not only that, plastic also emits one of the causes of global warming, like polystyrene and other plastic containers. I mean, from the precious petrochemicals, do not decompose in landfills and release toxic gases when they are burned in seniors. So my message was to take care of our beautiful home, because if you don't, the next century might not see the beauty of our planet like we see in our childhood. Thank you so much.